pretty.
What you want to do when you tie them up, now I bring lots of Pine Street down here to Sheridan. What we're going to do, we're going to do a serpentine line that it gives this tomato plant. It's going to be around this. We're not going to tie it to the tomato plant. We're going to bring it over and we're going to tie it back here. That will give that plant room to slide in and out. You don't want to choke that tomato plant. So you're going to give him a couple of inches where it, this string's a little bit short. It needs to be a little bit longer. But I'll do that all the way up that plank. Now, why do I use a steel stake? I use it by choice. Again, I could use tomato cages. They've got plenty of them. They work well. This just works better for me personally, as a personal choice only. These cages will work well too. The only thing about the cages that I dislike, well, there's two or three things. Well, one of them is they're not really angry. They're not really anchored good to the ground. If it comes a monsoon thunderstorm and the winds are 45 miles an hour, it will lay them down. This will not be laid down. It's going to take something bad happen, earthquakes, something bad. When it comes time to sucker that plank, I'm going to keep him suckered all summer long. I'm going to have everything going into tomatoes and tomato blooms. I don't want anything going into unnecessary growth. I want all the nutrients, all the moisture going into that plant. When he gets up right this tall, he needs to be topped. He doesn't need to be 10 foot tall because you're going to get him something to pick your tomatoes. He needs to level out right here. And they will be fine topped. They don't mind it a bit. So we're going to do that. Let me put these others in.
Do we?